In this illustration, we intend to simulate the seepage in the anisotropic soil in the Abaqus software. The height of the water reservoir is 3 meters and the embedded length of the sheet pile is 4.6 meters. The simulation is aimed at drawing the flow net, which can be observed in the picture. In the next picture, you can observe the equipotential lines, and in the next one, the flow lines can be seen. Actually, we intend to simulate the example 9.6 from Sam Helwani book in the Abaqus software. I will enter the Abaqus software for simulation. I will click on Create Part. I intend to create geometric shape of soil. I select the modeling space as two-dimensional of deformable type. From here, shell, and put the rough size of the tracing page as 100 and continue. Here, I'll draw a rectangle. As explained in the book, the height of the soil is 9.2 meters. And the length of soil is equal to 54 meters. I will click on Done. In the next step, as explained in the book, a narrow V-shaped gap will be used in order to simulate the sheet piles. To do so, I'll click on Create Cut, Extrude. Here, I will draw a vertical line. The embedded length of the sheet piles is equal to 4.6 meters. I will enter the distance between this point and this one equal to 27 meters. In the next step, I will draw two slanting lines. In this manner, and enter the distance between this point and this one equal to 2 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 2 meters. Then I will enter the distance between this point and this one equal to 2 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 2 meters. In the next step, I will complete the shape as it can be seen here. In the next step, I'll click on Auto Trim and remove this line and click on Done. In this manner, the sheet piles will be created. Actually, we utilize a narrow V-shaped gap, and you can observe here. In the next step, I'll enter Property module, click on Create Material. Here, I intend to define properties of the soil. I will select Elasticity and Elastic from Mechanical menu. The Young modulus is equal to 68 multiplied by 10 to the power of 6 Pascal, and the Poisson ratio is equal to 0.3. I will select Pore Fluid and Permeability from the other menu. Many natural sedimentary soils are anisotropic with respect to permeability. Their horizontal permeabilities are significantly greater than their vertical permeabilities. Since the soil is anisotropic, here I will select orthotropic. The coefficient of permeability in the horizontal direction is equal to 15 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 5 meters per second. The coefficient of permeability in the vertical direction is 5 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 5 meters per second. and the coefficient of permeability in z direction is equal to 15 multiplied by 10 to the power of negative 5 meters per second. I will enter the void ratio equal to 1. Here we should enter a specific weight of water, so I will enter 10,000 and OK. In the next step, I will click on Create Section, select Solid and Homogeneous from here, and click on OK. In the next step, I will click on Assign Section, select the soil, Done, and OK. In the next step, I'll click on Assign Material Orientation, select the soil, Done. Here, I'll click on Use Default Orientation or other method. As you can observe in this picture, direction 1 is actually the same x-axis and direction 2 is the same y-axis. So I'll click on OK. In the next step, I'll enter Assembly Module. Click on Create Instance. Here I will select the soil and OK. In the next step, I'll enter Step Module. Click on Create a Step. Here I'll select Soils. Continue. I will select Steady State in the Pore Fluid Response section. Since we don't intend to calculate deformations in this question, the analysis will be done in linear form. Here I will tick off this option and click on OK. In the next step, I'll enter Load Module. Click on Create Load. From here, I'll select Body Force and Continue. Then I'll select Soil, Done. Here we should enter the specific weight of soil. So I'll enter 7,000 and OK. In the next step, I'll click on Create Predefined Field. From here, I'll select Initial, then Void Ratio and Continue. I'll select Soil, Done, enter Initial Void Ratio equal to 1, and OK. In the next step, I'll click on Create Boundary Condition. Here, select Displacement Rotation and Continue. Then, I will select Soil and Done. Here, I'll close the boundary conditions of U1, U2, and UR3. Since we are not going to calculate the deformations in this question, I'll close all the boundary conditions for the whole of the soil. And then click on OK. In the next step, I'll click on Create Boundary Condition. Select Step 1 from here. I will select Other in the Category section. Then Pore Pressure and Continue. Then I will select the upstream of the soil. There is a water reservoir with a height of 3 meters in the upstream section of the soil. This water reservoir causes a pore water pressure as much as 30 kilopascal to be applied to the upstream of the soil. Here I will click on Done and enter the pore water pressure equal to 30,000 Pascal. In the next step, I will click on Create Boundary Condition, select Pore Pressure and Continue. Then I will select Downstream of the Soil and Done, and enter the pore water pressure equal to 0 for it and OK. In the next step, I will enter Mesh Module, click on Seed Part, enter the size of granulation equal to 0.5 meters and OK. Then I'll click on Assign Mesh Control. From here I'll select Quad, Structured and Medial Axis and OK. In the final step, I'll click on Mesh Part and Yes. Then I'll click on Assign Element Type, select the soil and Done. Put the element family on pore fluid stress and OK. In the next step, I'll enter Job Module, click on Create Job. Here we intend to draw the equipotential lines, so I will click on continue and OK, and here click on submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I'll click on result. Then I'll click on plot contours. Here I will select pore pressure. Then remove meshing from the model. Okay. Then I'll click on contour option. Here select isosurface. Then put contour interval on 6 and apply and OK. Here you can observe the equipotential lines having been drawn in the Abaqus software. In the next step, I will enter load module, then select copy model from the model menu. Here I will type the name of flow lines and OK. Here I intend to draw the flow lines. To do so, first I'll click on boundary manager condition. Here click on edit. Then click on this arrow and select the bottom of the soil and done. In this manner, the pore water pressure on the bottom of the soil would be equal to 30,000 Pascal. In the next step, I'll click on edit, then this arrow, then select the sheet piles and done and OK. In this manner, the pore water pressure of the sheet piles will become equal to zero. In the next step, I will enter job module, click on create. Here, select flow lines. Continue. OK. Then I'll click on submit. The analysis was done successfully, so I will click on result. I will select pore pressure from here, then put contour interval on 3 and OK. Here you can observe the flow lines. In the next step, I'll click on create from the viewport menu, then click on tile horizontally. You can observe flow lines in the above picture and in the below picture. You can observe the equipotential lines. Here, if the flow lines are placed over the equipotential lines, the flow net will be formed. And you can observe in this picture the flow net having been drawn in the Abaqus software.